Economic activities in parts of Ibadan affected by last month's flooding are yet to fully recover. A six-hour downpour swept away lives and property. Several hundreds have been displaced and over 100 lives were lost. Although reconstruction is rapidly going on in some parts like Oluyole Estate and Akwete, where bridges were swept away, debris and electric poles litter other parts where the flooding was severe. Dauda Ajitumabi is a welder in one of the areas where power supply has been affected. He says it's not been easy breaking even because of increased cost of generating his own power.
But this thing, within 2 days, by 4,000 naira, in this amount of buy. So, this one, 145 naira per liter. So, I'm going to have 27 liters, 4,000 naira. Because I'm also complaining. But I'm not my donor. To see how the choice to get to the money.
Ajitumabi may be one of the few lucky ones that own a generator. There are others that don't have such opportunity. Dupe Komolafe is a tailor and says before the power cut, she could attend to 10 customers a day and make 3 dresses. Her income could be at least 4,000 naira a day. Kunle Ajibola runs a small-scale business making polythene bags. He says he's losing about 100,000 naira each day due to lack of power.
My brother, not easy at all. Kazi, as you are just coming, you met us sit down outside here without doing anything. So,
why don't you buy a generator like other people?
Generator, and I'm on you. require a lot of money from us.
For Benis Kazim, sales have gone down and she struggles to keep her bottled water business going. Jide Oyinuga of the Power Holding Company of Nigeria gives an idea of the extent of damage and what to expect.
When we're talking about 100%, there are some pockets that are still coming in that have not been fully taken care of, but I know it runs into millions. In some areas, we talk about uprooting. You have to fill, you have to dig, you have to erect the poles, allow it to stabilize. Some cases, we have to beam with concrete and cement, and it takes a while for it to set before you can put the ladder and start sinking lines. It takes a while, but the engineers are there. They're working, and in a couple of days, we start restoration little by little. If we take a little pocket of community out and we can give them supply, that will have been a pass mark until the generality of the customers can come on board.
Other parts of Ibadan where there's power supply don't have the same experience. For them, it's business as usual. But for those whose businesses have been stalled by the lack of power, they can only hope that there's solution sooner than later. Kunle Idowu, NN24, Ibadan.